Hello guys, welcome to Master D Tutorials. This is Apoorv and we are on to our fifth tutorial for programming C language. In the last video I've told you that we are going to learn more about it, and so let's just say it's the beginning of C. In this video we are going to learn data types. As the name suggests, data types means the types of data supported in C languages. Data types are supported by a computer, and in C we have integer, float, double, characters, union, structures, and some more data types like arrays. So we are going to check them out one by one. So let's begin. I'm going to write and declare some variables of different data types. Let's begin with integer. Integer is a commonly used data type in any programming languages. So here integer is the data type where a is my variable, float b, similar to float and b, data type and variable respectively, double d and character c. So I have taken four data types here: integer, float, double and character. A, B, C, D are the variables of the data types respectively. So int is the keyword for integer data type. Float is for the float. Float values are like decimal values. You cannot give decimal values to integer, and double is also a decimal, can also accept decimal. Character is a 1-byte data type which can accept ASCII, extended ASCII characters. It can be a number or ABCD or a special characters. So integer here is a keyword. Keywords are predefined words in which are already used by C language, and you cannot use them to declare a variable. Similarly, float and double and character, if you write integer, integer means if you declare integer character, that is you try to declare a variable named as a keyword, it will give an error. So please don't try it. So guys, different data types have different sizes, and it depends on our use that during the runtime or what the user have to give. We use different data types. If the user gives the input of a character, we use character. If the user is giving an input that has decimals, we are using float values. And proper use of variables and data types can save us a lot of memory. Double can store an integer. It does not does not say no to the integer values, but double will take large space, more space. Of course, if you want to store a value of 1 or 0, you will not assign double to it. So this and one more thing, strings are not supported in C. Strings are supported in C++. In C you declare a string using an array of characters, while in C++ you have a data type string. So guys, I'll just take some input from the user to different data types and print on the screen and show you something. Scanf is the function used to take input from the user, while printf was used to print on the screen. Scanf is used to scan. So how we take input is we use format specifier, that is percentage dfl or c depending on the data type. It is percentage d for integer. A is the variable name in which I have to store the value. So you can see that percentage d is a format specifier that the input is an integer and we have to store in a variable. So I'll just copy paste and change it according to the data type. Here lf is for our double character c, and let me change the name of the variables as well, d and c. So will, according to this program, we will be taking input from the user, that is me, and printing the respective values. So after the comma, we are using the variable name, and printf, there's an error. It's printf. So copy paste again, it's easy, and changing the values for the format specifiers. LF again for double and character C. For scanning the values to the variables, we need ampersand sign before the variable name to specify the address where we have to save this. After running, I'll just input four values. The first value is integer, so I'm writing 67. The second value is a float value, so I am writing a decimal point. The third value is a double, so I'm going to write a long number. So there has been an error. We are not able to write a fourth input, that is our character. So there has been an error, and the error is just small, that we have used the character name C, which is forbidden. There are some names, variable names, which you cannot use for that particular data type. As for printing the character, we use percentage C. That's why we cannot use C as a variable of character. Similarly for double and for float. So this was about data types in C. If you have any queries, please write in the comment section. And if you like this tutorial, please give us a like. Thank you.